Howdy. Today I'll be disassembling this laptop. It's a Compaq CQ61, which is overheating. I'll be applying paste to it and cleaning the cooling fan. With all that said, before disassembling, you would have to remove the battery pack and taking out some screws. Now I have this, which I'll be placing the screws on, because I don't know if they are different sizes, so I would place them in the manner I take the screws out. I turn the laptop this way and let me begin. The video would be a two-part video because of the length it would be. I don't want to skip this process in removing the screws, because the whole purpose of this video is for you to do it yourself. Now you could either use the foam or you can use a piece of paper. As I stated, I do not know if the screws are the same length. That's the reason why I'm putting it on this piece of foam. That's the hard drive compartment. This is the hard drive. Only have two screws. It has this tab here, which you would pull forward. And these two screws here for the keyboard. These screws are shorter. The Wi-Fi compartment. You put this aside. I don't think you have to take out the memory, but you have a screw here. Another screw right here. I'll take out the CD-ROM. We have another screw here for the keyboard. I dropped that one. Then you will have a visual. I have two more here. And then you will have a visual, another one here. This laptop has more screws than. Okay, next you take out this. That could have stayed, but just take out. The cable, it's out already. Then remember, the Wi-Fi connection, the way it came out, but actually it's mapped 1 and 2. Then you do a visual to make sure that everything is out. The memory is on the board, so I won't be taking out the memory. and then you turn the laptop over. And start. Let me see if I miss a screw. Definitely did. You see, that's why we doing this video, so you won't make the mistakes that we do. When you get the keyboard out, you lift gently because there is a ribbon, it has a lid. You lift the lid up and you take the keyboard out. You put the lid back so it won't rip off. Then there is a screw right here. You would take out this ribbon, which doesn't have a key. But something I learned with these old laptops, you have to be very careful in taking out the ribbon, because the blue tab usually comes out. Just be careful with it and hold the ribbon and the blue tab and pull it out. And this is out. Then you disconnect everything on the board. I don't like holding the blue tab and pull out, because the blue tab has stayed in my hand. Already. What I didn't want to do is what I had to do. Then you will take out the monitor. The screen is out. Then you do a visual. Just to make sure there's a screw here. Do another visual, make sure you have everything, and then you will start separating the components. Now you have to be very careful when separating because it's plastic, it's clipped, and it could be broken. You see, nobody said this would have been easy, and look at how long the disassembling video already is, and it has three tabs here, which you'll try to get out. Once you see, go back down, it clicks back in place. This is it. You put this aside. And now you concentrate on do a visual again. Make sure nothing is left. Okay, this one here. Okay, and this ribbon here. Instead of taking out the ribbon, you know what, I'll just take out this screw. And now the keyboard, the motherboard is out. This is it. You put this case aside. I broke one of the tabs. Okay, the fan looked cleaner. You're taking out this. It doesn't matter how it comes out. What matters is how you put it back. That's the CPU fan. That's the thermal piece. It's a bit harder. I'm going to replace it. The fan itself looks cleaner. Yes, it is. I can see in through the fins. So let me clean some rubbing alcohol on this. And Q-tip. Okay, the fan looks new. It doesn't have dust, and I can see right through the fins of the fan. But if you do open yours and your fan is dirty, it has some screws here, 1, 2, 3, 4, and you would remove this plate to clean inside the fan. When replacing it, it's marked with numbers. This is 1, 2, 3. That's the tightening, the way you're supposed to tighten it. You take the thing after you put the piece and you line it up. When you've done that, this is number 1. You turn, this is number 2. You turn, this is number 3, and you would do it in that sequence all the time. Until you have it firm down. This is it for part 1 of this video. The reassembling would be in another video. If you find this was informative and educational, please like, subscribe, click on the bell icon to be notified of further videos. In some of my videos, some of my viewers and subscribers are thanking me for a job well done. I would appreciate it very much. Instead of thanking me, subscribe to my channel. This would bring the channel a long way. Thank you until part 2 of this video. Ready to let go.